Hi everyone, my name is Arvin Olano and welcome to my YouTube channel. So, nobody asked, but in today's video, we are giving my bedroom a little refresh. Let me start putting the room back together, and I'm so excited because today's video is sponsored by Dyson. So we've been using the Dyson Purifier Cool Formaldehyde for a few weeks now. It is multifunctional and there's purification benefits, plus it cools you, which is a huge benefit for us here in the desert. You guys know we're constantly doing home projects. I'm always moving furniture around, and the Dyson automatically senses, captures, and traps pollutants. It also detects and destroys formaldehyde released from household items. Formaldehyde is actually found in wood flooring, rugs, furniture, and fabrics. And many of these household items can actually release formaldehyde for years. And the HEPA filtration is gold standard, which is amazing. This Dyson purifier has been re-engineered to deliver 50% cleaner air than Dyson's first purifier. We have it on all throughout the night. The air that comes out is projected throughout the entire room and you can really feel it circulating. You can also download the Dyson app where you can set your purifier to automatically sense and react to pollution events so you can set it and forget it. Okay, so before we style the room up together, if you were inspired by the Dyson Purifier Cool Formaldehyde, make sure you go to Dyson.com. All the links will be down below in my description box to learn more. I've been very into the relaxed kind of bed styling with my linens lately, and I like kind of like the effortless look where you just toss the pillows, add a few colors, and this duvet is just so nice and fluffy. I just want to add one more color into the mix, so let me go ahead and get that. This bed blanket is from Parachute, and I believe it's in the color Terra. It's my favorite neutral that still gives you a punch of color, and we have been loving it here in the bedroom because our new nightstands are kind of like that burnt oak. So I feel like this really just complements the colors. Since I'm going for a relaxed look, the key is to not make it so perfect. The more wrinkles, the more kind of effortless it looks, the better. I always play around with different chairs in this corner. Andrew likes to sit down on this side and tie his shoes, kind of get ready for the day before he leaves to go run errands or, you know, do some work. So I kind of like how it ties in the darker tone wood of the nightstand. They're not the exact same color, and when you're mixing wood tones, please, 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 you don't have to match everything to the T because it starts to look like a showroom. We love a good mix of tones. I kind of want to add more to bring some life in this corner, so I'm going to put a little art piece right over here. We used to have a gallery wall in this area, and I took everything down because my style changed and I wanted something a little bit more minimal. It's bringing in those warm orangey tones that I love. This wall opposite to our bed is empty right now. I have no idea what to do here. And instead of trying to buy something just to fill a space, which you guys know is like a huge mistake, I'm just gonna leave it blank. This is actually where our Dyson is most of the time. That way, we're getting some wind, we're getting some air, and it's very dusty in here right now because we're moving all these things. So by the time we sleep tonight, the Dyson would have already purified the air. I get really bad allergy attacks, especially when there's a lot of dust and pollen. So by the way, my bedroom was just featured on Domino. I actually shared my hack on how to put a duvet cover on your bed in less than 5 minutes, and you guys, that hack is so much fun. You have to try the hack. I will link the article down below so you can check it out and learn how I put my duvet on. It's super easy once you do a little bit of practice. This is my side of the nightstand, and I think I'm gonna add some fresh florals just to give a little bit of life and some color into the bedroom. And I did like a really fun wispy arrangement. And I think the red, the green tones really go well with our bedding situation. Oh, there's also little yellow alliums that match my little yellow pillow. A few things that I always have to have on my nightstand is a good coaster. I got these from Amazon. They're kind of like a stone slate. And then this is a little bowl from one of my favorite vintage shops. It actually houses all of my rings. I'll usually throw my rings in here at the end of the night, so I'll just kind of leave that there. And I always, of course, need to have water, so I don't want to ruin that wood. We decided to get new nightstands because our old ones, we bought them on a whim when I knew nothing about design, I knew nothing about scale, and this wall of my bedroom is like really long and large, so I really wanted to fill the space with the proper sized nightstand. This is the Oak Brulee from Restoration Hardware, and something about this wood tone keeps like calling me back. Like, I love a good white oak, I love a good light wood, but when it's like a burnt, yummy, dark wood, I just like, it just like makes my heart like, just kind of like, a little flutter, you know? So, and I love it too because it adds a lot of contrast into our space. So before you buy a nightstand, make sure you measure it properly and you're really kind of filling up the walls. That way it looks more luxurious, looks more grand. The mirror is old. It's actually from Zara Home, but I found almost the exact, like literally the exact same thing from an Etsy seller. So I'll make sure to link this down below. This lamp is probably not gonna go anywhere anytime soon. It was my first luxury designer home goods lamp. Another thing I wanted to talk about was our bed. It actually got a little bit damaged during the renovation. The foam is like all out of place and it's a dupe of the Restoration Hardware Cloud bed. Unfortunately, it just, we have to replace it because it got ruined and just not, it's not the same anymore. So we are thinking of ordering a custom bed from RH. I don't know if we're gonna do the Cloud or the Modena, but I don't want white, which is a shocker. I don't want a white bed. I want it to be like a kind of toffee coffee linen brown, I think. Almost the same color as the nightstand, maybe a little bit lighter. We just recently painted the walls Simply White by Benjamin Moore. It's my favorite warm white. I remember during our renovation, we actually used our Dyson purifier to make sure all the dust, all of the nasty smells are out of the bedroom. These sheer curtains are my famous, iconic Amazon find. This used to be in my studio, but it's here now. They're pinch pleated, about $120 for a set of two, which you can even customize them. It is that good. I recommend this to everybody that's looking for shears. Mine is in the shade Ivory. I forgot to mention, on this side of the bedroom is our TV. And I have been telling Andrew for almost 2 years to kind of switch it, to make it like straight, you know? Cause like, okay, can you tell him like it's crooked? And he's like, no, it's not crooked, it's fine. When we were planning this bedroom refresh, restyling, we actually ordered a few things that just did not arrive in time. Things are back ordered like crazy. And one of them is a chandelier. We actually ordered this one from the Amber Lewis for Anthropology collaboration. And I love like, I love the shapes, the lines and the shades. So beautiful. It's not coming until like November, I don't know. Okay, next I wanna try styling the foot of the bed with this bench. It's brand new. It was so affordable. It has like a really beautiful boucle texture and, oh, I'm stuck. I feel like it's nice because it has like these black iron legs that I feel match just the curtain rod we have up there. Do you like it? Do you not like it? I love having something at the foot of the bed for me to like sit down, maybe chat with Andrew. Actually, the boys love sleeping on this little thing. It's really comfortable. And again, it was so affordable. I think like $160 and it looks so high end, so good. Hold on, I'm gonna try something else at the foot of the bed. I have these really cute ottomans from one of my favorite vintage dealers on Instagram. And I feel like ottomans also like look really cute on the bed. Okay, do we like that? Oh my gosh, it's literally so hot. I'm gonna turn my Dyson up just a little bit more. I love how the air on the Dyson is projected like in one direction, but it actually circulates throughout the entire room, and whew, it is so hot today, you guys. Final decision, I think I'm liking the bench. Yeah, I'm really digging it. All right, everyone, that was it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you felt inspired by the Dyson Purifier, don't forget to visit Dyson.com. Also, don't go yet. Go ahead and watch my Stop Doing This in Your Kitchen video. We are having a blast in the comment section as per usual, am I right? Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, everyone.